What we are focusing on with our therapy is glaucoma. It is, of course, one of the most prevalent diseases in ophthalmology, also one of the most pressing, leading to irreversible blindness, and 70 million people are suffering from it. Now, there is, of course, standard of care that is looking at slowing down disease progression by means of lowering the IOP. So focus on the eye, on the IOP, with either drugs or with surgical solutions. Now, while all of that is absolutely necessary, it is not sufficient to treat patients with glaucoma. What we do see, there is about 15% of patients who are refractory to drug treatment, and then there's another about a third of the patients who are NTG, normal tension glaucoma patients. Now, it has been established that glaucoma is linked to neuropathies of the optic nerve, and I think this is also what you see when you look at fundoscopy. You see that structurally changes have happened in patients suffering from glaucoma, and that you then also, when you look at the perimetry, to see that these patients indeed also functionally have impairment, they have lost of vision. So the point being that there's more to glaucoma than just the eye. It's this vital link between the eye and the visual cortex, the optic nerve, that deserves our focus when we look at treating glaucoma. Now, this is just a sketch of the optic nerve, the nerve fibers, the axons, and the endpoints being the retinal ganglion cells. When you do have an event happen to the optic nerve, it can be inflammation, can be trauma, can be ischemic, not all tissue is lost. So structurally, not all tissue is affected by this. It is still intact. It's just lost its function. And that is why patients then see blurred vision or lose their sight. And this is where stimulation comes in, stimulation of the optic nerve that then reactivates those tissue cells that have not been structurally destroyed but just have been dormant. So these dormant cells are being reactivated back to function thanks to neurostimulation. The underlying mechanism of action being that you increase neurotrophic factors, you increase perfusion and get a triple effect, being structural neurorestoration, functional neurorestoration, as well as neuroprotection, leading then to the hypothesis that you should also be able, by doing so, recover vision in patients who suffer from neuropathies of the optic nerve, such as glaucoma. Now, there was a lot of work done in Japan in particular on this. So here you have one of the works done by Tagami, published in 2009, where on rats you had nerve crush being performed, and then in the treatment group you applied ONS and compared then the two. You see in the upper one nerve crush only, so the eye would be on the left-hand side. And in the lower one you see the animals that were treated with ONS, clearly showing regeneration after optic nerve crush by applying optical nerve stimulation. Similarly, if you look at functional neurorestoration, also there work done by Miyake, that on the left-hand side you see the animal that was treated, on the right-hand side animal untreated after nerve crush. We do see the visually evoked potential, the amplitude going up after 6 hours and also 1 week in the animal being treated, and if you get a flatliner in the animal that did not receive any treatment. And then also in terms of neuroprotection, there is the preclinical evidence here. If you look at the two different images, the lower one being animals after a transection of the optic nerve, where you do see that you get about twice as many retinal ganglion cells than in the non-treated group. So the question then is, if we say that electrical ONS can actually have as effect neurorestoration and neuroprotection, how you translate that now from animal into humans? Now, interestingly, neurostimulation and neuromodulation is widely applied in other medical fields, such as movement disorders, Parkinson's disease, deep brain stimulation, pain, also epilepsy, but not in ophthalmology. And the reason why this is so surprising is that actually the first ever proof that electricity does trigger nervous response was done by a physician in the ophthalmic space 250 years ago, Charles Leroy, who actually did use non-invasive stimulation on blind patients and could trigger with that perception of light. So those clearly were not optic signals traveling to the cortex. It was an electrical signal that was being processed by the visual cortex. And this is also, and you see on the right-hand side, the system that we are using. It's a non-invasive electromodulation device. So stimulation goggles that the patients do get for 10 working days in a row, 60 minutes, where we also use this phenomenon, the phosphenes, those light flashes, as a threshold for treatment. We have done three randomized controlled trials, the largest of which with 82 patients also served as the basis for obtaining CE mark. So we have obtained CE mark already with this device. You see after 3 months, a decline or a decrease in mean defect of these patients. This is after 3 months. Also, when you look at the perimetry, you have two specimens there where you see a treatment after 12 days, and then after 3 months, you see that the visual field of these patients does improve when they are treated with optic nerve stimulation. So you see that you can stop disease progression, but also even give back vision to these patients thanks to reactivating those ganglion cells. And we also, 5 weeks ago, could present at the German Society Meeting of Ophthalmology in Berlin now the 12-month data, where you see that 76% of the treated eyes actually did show stop of disease progression, and only 5 eyes actually continued, as you might expect in glaucoma patient to continue. I think more importantly also, we've seen also here confirmation that in some of those eyes you also do get significant drop in IOP. If you look at 8, 18, and 19 on the slide, you see that there is a improvement in 12 months as well. So in summary, preclinical proof that neuromodulation in ophthalmology works, also clinical proof as shown in the patient data. We have treated 300 patients so far in Germany only, in 6 centers, and we are preparing U.S. market access with a randomized controlled trial that we want to kick off next year. Thank you.